Hi guys, welcome to another video. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can set up TikTok pixel for your Shopify store. Now, it is really important to set up pixel because if you're running ads on TikTok and you haven't yet set up TikTok pixel, then you will not be able to optimize your campaign and you will not be getting any conversion, meaning the platform will not be able to track if you're getting any sales from your campaign because it won't be optimizing or it won't be using the AI system to optimize the sales for you. So if you are running a TikTok campaign and you haven't yet set up TikTok pixel, then you are literally wasting all of your money. So make sure to watch the complete video in which I'll show you guys a step-by-step process where you can set up TikTok pixel in a super simple way and without using any code. We will be using a free app called NS TikTok Pixels and TikTok Ads. And this app is super simple to implement, and it is going to basically give you an events API which you can set up, and it is also going to add server-side tracking, which can be very helpful if you are losing conversions due to the browser restrictions. So if you want to learn, make sure to watch the complete video. I'll give you a step-by-step process on how you can do this with NS TikTok Pixel and TikTok Ads. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. So guys, this is the app which you will need to install. All you will have to do is just click on install button here. I already have it installed. That's why it's giving me open. And once you install the app and click on pixel management, you will have a screen like this. I'm going to click on add pixel. And here, let's select manual input pixel. I'm going to add in the name. You can add whatever you want. I'm going to add YouTube tutorial just for the sake of this tutorial. And here we need to create a pixel ID. Now, if you haven't yet created a pixel, I'm going to show you how you can create on your TikTok business account. So that is the business account of TikTok, which I have opened. You will need to open this URL, which says business.tiktok.com. And once you go there, click on assets and then click on add a pixel. So go to this URL, click on assets, and then click on add a pixel. I already have this test pixel created, but once you click on add a pixel, you will be redirected to a screen like this. And from there, you will need to click on connect data source. Click on connect data source and here click web, click on next, and then add in your store URL. I'm going to add my development store URL, which is this one here. So I'm going to copy this from here and paste it here. Right? Make sure you add in your live store URL. Then click on next. And from here, click on manual step. Then click on next. And from here, click on TikTok pixel plus events API. Click on next. I'm going to name my pixel same as I did on my app and then click on create. Now our pixel is created and we will see all of these instructions where we need to install the code. But in this case, we are using NS TikTok pixel, so we don't need to manually add in any code. Click on next, and from manage configurations, again, you don't have to do anything. Just click on next, 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 next. Next. And finally, we have this finish button showing up. I'm going to click on finish. And now here you're seeing that we have this pixel ID showing up, which we will need to paste into our app. So click on this icon to copy the pixel ID and then paste in here. Okay, now here we have the option to select entire store. So if you want to track entire store for this pixel, or if you want to select any specific collection, we can select it from here. Or if we want to select a specific product, we can also do that here, right? But in this case, we will select the entire store. And here we have the option to enable event API, which is Shopify pixel will be initialized immediately after the saving, right? So I'm gonna enable that. And now we need to add in the access token and test event. Okay, now I'm going to add access token and test event code here. So let's go to event manager.
click on settings, scroll down. Here we will see generate access token option. Click on generate access token. And here I'm going to copy this access token, paste it here. And then for test event, we will go to test events. And here we will have the option here, which is our test event code. So I'm simply going to copy this code here and paste it here and then click on save. Perfect. You can see that we have our pixel added. Now I'm going to tell you another way to connect your pixel, which is going on settings. Make sure first you have enable app option. So that was the first part, which we didn't cover on the video. Before even connecting to the pixel, make sure you have this enable app enabled on your published theme. So click on enable, which will take you directly to the theme app embed page. And here you can see this TikTok ads integration, and then click on save after enabling that. Now go back to our old tab and then click refresh, where you will see that app embed is now enabled. You can see that we have this enabled option showing up, right? Now we're going to click on connect TikTok ad account. Click on connect. And then click on confirm. Okay, after connecting the ad account, click on pixel management. And here you have this old pixel showing up. We're going to integrate the new one with auto pixel option. Click on add pixel. And here you will have this option of auto pixel input. Once you select that, name your pixel. You will have your ad account showing up here, and you will have your pixel also showing up here, right? I'm going to select that. Again, tracking location can be based on your preference. I'm going to select entire store. Make sure that TikTok ad account time zone is same as your TikTok ad account. I'm going to leave it as it is for now. Enable event API, and for this test event, we're going to go to our events manager. So that's the events which is showing up on our app. You can match it by the pixel ID. So if you notice this pixel ID, we have it same as this one here, which automatically showed up on the drop-down menu. Now I'm going to add in the test event code here. So again, click on test events, and here you have this code showing up. I'm simply going to copy it here and paste. Once done, click on save. And here we have our auto pixel integrated to entire store. Okay guys, I'm going to deactivate this pixel here and then track the analytics for this pixel. So let's give some activity to this pixel and see what we get. So I'm gonna add in some text activity, meaning our pixel should be tracked and it will be showing us all the data in the analytics. Okay, here we have our store loaded. I'm gonna view some of the products. So I'm just giving test activity to see if it's showing up in our analytics page or not, right? I'm just gonna visit a couple of the products and then click on buy it now to proceed with the checkout. Now, whatever activity I did on my store, it's gonna be tracked on my pixel, which will be passed on to the TikTok campaign. So if I go to now the app and then click on pixel analytics, it's gonna take some time to load the data. And here you go, you can see that we have this data showing up for this pixel, which we selected, right? It's gonna take 3 to 4 minutes to update the latest data. So if you are not seeing anything, make sure to hold for like 3 to 4 minutes in order to view the data. Perfect. Now we can also create ads campaign directly from this app. So if we click on Smart Ads Management and then click on Create Smart Ad. Here you can see that we have our ad account connected. I'm going to name the campaign to be Test Campaign. Pixel ID will be showing up, which you already connected. And here is the optimization event. Now you can select view content, and but obviously you are running a Shopify store, so you should be optimizing for the purchase event, meaning whenever you get a purchase, it will note down the user profile and the behavior, and then further it will optimize via the AI. I'm talking about the TikTok platform, where it will enhance and view your ad more to those people who are more willing to make this optimization event purchase to trigger more, right? So this purchase event is more triggered and it will serve your ad to the relevant audience. Here we can select the daily budget. Let's add in the 10 euro, or it's adding, selecting to add the minimum 20 euro. Here you have the option to set targets CPA. Initially, I don't think you need to set the target CPA, but you can if you want to. And I would select like 20 euro as target CPA. So it is cost per acquisition, meaning 20 euro will be the cost of your acquisition of that sale. Location, you can select any location like United States, or here we have option of United Arab Emirates only. I'm not sure why the other countries are not showing up. Maybe some restriction with the TikTok. But anyway, let's select the language. I'm going to select the language to be English. Here you need to add in the product URL. So if you are selling this product, let's suppose I'm going to add in the URL of this product here. So copy this URL, paste this URL here. And here you can upload your ads directly from here. So click on add creatives from library and then upload the video. I currently don't have any creative, but whenever you upload the creative and add in the text, it will show up the preview of the ad here. And after everything is done, you can add more text variation as well for your ad. And once done, you can simply click on save and your ad campaign will be ready. Obviously, it's saying giving me error because I haven't yet uploaded the creative and haven't yet added the text. But that's all you have to do in order to completely integrate with TikTok. That's it for this video, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you have any confusion. Until next video, have a great day.